Islam, all over the world, all over Africa, all over the global, the whole continent of Africa, the whole world. This is Prophet Anthony Mofriwa. If you were ever watching from, you want to come and see me. God has called you, whether from Kitwe, from South Africa, wherever you are, you want to work with us. You are most welcome. If you want to come and see me one-on-one, just make an appointment to come and see me one-on-one. We have money to get the church plot, and we are building the church plot. We want to build a 50,000 capacity, but we are going to start small. The Lord has blessed us. We have got the anointing and power. Many things are happening. We have seen the dead people coming back. We have seen many people being healed. So the project has already started. As you are watching it, the project has started. I'm urging you that you can still support this program. The question is, God will ask you one day, when you were on the earth, what did you do for my work? What did you do for my work? You're not just surviving for the sake of just existing, but you will survive for the sake of the work of God to go far. So I'm urging you, I'm talking to you, that car, take it as a seed. That prod, take it as a seed. You know, some of us were given bigger things, our iPads, our phone. Some of us were given our suits. We have given a lot of money. Even this program that you are watching on TV, I sponsored. So I'm talking to you that you can become one of the partners of this program. You can partner with me in this program. I want to touch many, many souls. I'm praying to God that this night of entrance and crossover, we want to be at Nungush Conference, or we want to be somewhere like Gabriel Conference or the stadium. So I'm urging everyone, if you are very far, you cannot mind to come to church on Sunday. You can just send your money on Airtel money or on MTN money. Then you call for prophecy. We are not charging, but we are just asking you to contribute for this program to continue. You see, I'm not working. I don't sign anywhere at month end. The only work that I'm doing, it is the work of God. So I'm urging you to support. And I don't want to continue using members to come and do the work of God. Kabang is very far with Choston, and it's very difficult. But we are trying by all means that we can still serve God. We want to buy a bus that can pick people around Lusaka. We want to build a very big church capacity. The project has already started. I'm urging, I'm inviting you. Our services every 8 hours up to 13 hours Sundays. And every Friday, 16 hours up to 19 hours every Friday. Within the week, it's one-on-one session. You have to make an appointment and book and see me one-on-one. God bless you. Shalom. Oh, glory be to Jesus. Let's go to the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 33. The Bible says, "But seek first the kingdom of God in his righteousness, and all things will be given to you." Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things will be given to you. That's where many people are missing today. People right now, as I'm talking, they're lining up and they're looking for money. As I'm talking, people are lining up and down, seeking for money, seeking for employment, seeking for promotion. The question is, what do you want to do for God's kingdom? We are building the church. We want your finances. We want your support. You might be going to another church, but this is the mission of God. The kingdom of God is one. You're not supporting me. You're not supporting the church. You're supporting God's work, God's mission. Listen, if you take the money you give to a man of God, it will be an indirect answer from God. But if you take the money you give to the work of God, this program on TV here, you have given that money into God's hand direct. Because, you know, then one time I was on TV here, an ambassador called me. She was watching. And they removed me because the time was very short, 30 minutes only. She was very upset with the Prime TV. I told her, no, don't be upset with Prime TV. It is the sponsorship that I don't have enough. I need more than partners that can sponsor this program. You see, share that number that you're watching there to 20 people and call me for prophecy. Share that number to 20 people and call me for prophecy. And the Lord is talking to more than 30 people who are going to be partners of this program. Partners of this program. I'm seeing someone, the Lord is raising you. You are going to plant the seed of a car. A seed of a car. Let me pick a call. There are a lot of thousands of people that are calling. Many, many people are calling. Let me pick a call. See, make sure as you call, stay away from your TV. Make sure when you call me, share that number again to someone. You know, it is the time to prove to this country and to prove to the people that they are prophets in Zambia here. Let me pick a call. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir, how are you?
Fine,
you are calling from where?
I'm calling from the airport.
From?
From the airport.
From the airport. Okay, I'm live on TV right now. I'm live on TV right now. Can I prophesy to you?
Yes.
Okay. I'm seeing you are working somewhere, sir.
Come again, sir.
I'm seeing you are working somewhere and you are now working somewhere again.
Working?
Yes, I'm seeing you are working somewhere, working.
No, sir, I'm not working at the moment.
I'm seeing you were working somewhere. Yeah, but now you are not you are looking to work for somewhere. Hello?
Yes, I'm getting what I'm
saying, sir. I'm saying there is another job that's coming for you now.
Yes.
Okay. Then I'm seeing a woman. Are you married?
I'm married. I'm with my wife here.
You're good.
Oh,
That's why you called for the sake of your wife. Hello?
Hello?
That's why you have called for the sake of your wife.
Yes, and myself and myself, my wife.
Okay. So now, I'm seeing God giving a job now. Okay, are you ready for that job?
Yes.
Yeah, then your wife, there is a problem over her neck. Then again, the feet are paining right now.
Yes, she's not feeling well all over the body. She's complaining here and there.
Okay, can God heal her right now?
Yes, let me give you a moment. I will hear.
Okay.
Hello?
Hello, Mama.
Hello.
Okay, I'm seeing the devil attacking you all over your body. The legs are paining. In the neck again. This is not malaria.
Yes.
It's not malaria, it's just an attack that has come on your body.
Yes.
Can I prophesy to you?
Yes, you prophesy.
Okay, there is a lady by the name Elizabeth. Hello?
Yes,
do you know her?
Yes, she's a friend.
She is a friend. I'm seeing this lady, she's having problem to settle in marriage.
Okay.
Hello?
Hello, I can get.
Yes, I'm seeing this lady, she's failing to settle in marriage. The lady Elizabeth. The name Elizabeth, I'm seeing this lady failing to settle in marriage. Okay, I'm seeing business. Who is doing business? Is the same lady, Elizabeth? Okay, so tell her, because I'm not seeing her in a permanent church, so I need to see her tomorrow.
Yes,
yeah, tomorrow. So now, they have attacked your life. You see, you are feeling the pain all over the body. Then I'm seeing another lady by the name Sarah. I don't know if it's Sarah or Sarah. Or I don't know if it's Sarah, but the name would sound like that.
Huh?
Eh? Is it Stella or Sela?
Stella.
Okay, Stella.
Yes.
Okay, I'm seeing her again, the business again.
Yes.
Okay, so now God wants to heal you. You are feeling the pain all over the body right now.
Me?
Eh. The hands and the leg. What about your neck?
Even the neck.
Okay. I was mentioning right here. So now, can God heal you right now?
Yes.
Okay. Let me pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't stand, you may fall. Just kneel down. I want to pray for you. Don't stand, you may fall. The power of God is so strong here.
Right.
In the name of Jesus, be healed. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Mama.
Yes.
I'm seeing an angel where you are right now, touching you.
Yes.
And you are healed. Can you stand up? Are you feeling any pain now? Stand up, stand up. Stand up, stand up.
Yes.
Are you standing?
Yes, I'm standing.
Are you feeling any pain on your body? Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I am healed.
I am healed.
Okay, do you still are you still feeling the pain right now?
Yes, on the left leg.
On your left leg. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Say, I'm free. Say, I'm free.
I'm free.
Are you feeling the pain anymore? Say, in Jesus' name, I'm healed now.
In Jesus' name, I'm healed now.
Are you still feeling it?
Not very much.
Are you feeling it?
Just a bit.
Okay, now you are healed. Say, I'm healed.
I'm healed.
Say, I'm healed in Jesus' name.
I'm healed in Jesus' name.
Now, Mama, I'm seeing that pain that was on your neck gone. I'm seeing that pain again that was in. On your leg is gone. The pain that was on your feet, on your arms again, it's gone. And the
it's on my arms.
Hey, it's gone, yeah.
Yes.
The neck pain is gone.
On the left leg.
Left leg.
The right leg is
not there. The pain that was on your right leg, the pain that was on your neck, the pain that was on your hands, and the pain that was on your right leg is gone, but only the left leg. That is a sign of stroke, Mama. So I want to command that demon of stroke. Are you ready for freedom?
Sorry?
That's a sign of stroke on the left leg.
Yes.
It's a demon. That one is going right now. It's a demon of stroke.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Ouch.
Yes. Ouch.
Are you feeling it now? Are you, do you still have that pain?
Just on the arm.
Just, okay, can you bend your leg? Can you bend your leg? Bend your leg, stretch out and stretch in. Bend in and bend out, bend it. And you already healed. If the leg, that the pain that was on your neck is gone, the pain on your arms are gone, and the pain that was on your right leg is gone, only the left leg, it's a demon. So that's a stubborn spirit. Just say, just bend your leg, bend 3 times. Are you still feeling a pain?
Yes.
Are you still feeling a pain?
Yes, on the knee side.
On your knee. Bend is the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say, in the name of Jesus. Mama.
Ma, sorry.
There are a lot of people are calling. I'm saying, say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Ouch! Are you still feeling that pain?
Yes.
Are you still feeling the pain or it's gone?
It's still there.
Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
The stroke is gone.
Stroke is gone.
I am free.
I am free.
Begin to do left right. 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 Are you doing it?
Sorry?
Begin to do left, right. Are you doing left, right?
Yes.
Do left, right, continue, left, right, continue. Are you doing it?
Yes.
Okay, say, are you free now?
Yes, at least.
At least is gone.
Yes.
God bless you so much. Clap hands for Jesus wherever you are.
Yes.
Say, thank you, Jesus, I'm healed. Okay, now I want to see you tomorrow with your husband.
Okay.
Yes.
What time?
Somewhere 8-9.
Okay.
The service is 8-9, yeah? You call me. 8-9, we are in Kamanga, opposite Kamanga Primary School.
Okay.
God bless you so much. You see, wherever you're watching from, you see, how can it... Wherever you're watching from, you see, this is very amazing. This is very amazing. I have prophesied that there is a lady by the name of Stella, and I said that she's a business lady. She has confirmed to be true. You were watching here. I've also mentioned about Elizabeth, that she is failing to settle in marriage. She has said it's true. I've mentioned about the husband that used to work somewhere, but is no longer working. He has confirmed to be true. I've mentioned about the wife being sick, you see. She had pains all over the body. The most painful part, it was on the neck, the hands, and the both legs. The both legs, one right leg was healed, but the other one was difficult. I had to find out from God. I discovered it was a demon of stroke. After struggling this demon, praying for it, right on the team, it is gone. What are you waiting for? You see, someone you are watching me, the Lord has spoken to you that you have to plant the seed of a car. You have to plant the seed of a car. You have to plant the seed again, another one for the land for the church. Want to build a 50 seat capacity in Osaka, a 50,000 seat capacity church. I'm believing God that we are going to have international visitors all over the world coming to Zambia. But we need your support. We need your help. You see, some of you are watching, you are very far. You say, maybe I cannot manage. The number you are watching, you are seeing on the TV, that number, get that number. Send your offering for the support of this program. You send it on Airtel Money. When you send that man on Airtel Money, call me for prophecy. That is your offering. The Bible says, God told Abraham, take your son to the altar for me to speak to you, for me to protect you. See, when Abraham took the son to the altar, God spoke to him. God opened the door. He says, if blessing, I'll bless you. If protection, you know, it will take you to take a seat, you to take a step. You know, one day I was on TV, and another lady, she was watching live, but she was about to die in Ichilanga. And this lady called, after calling the lady, she said, prophet, I'm about to die. Pray for me before I die. I said, mama, you're not going to die. After praying for her, she got healed, and the Lord healed her from the spirit of death. She's still alive as I'm talking. One day again, I was on TV. Then I prophesied, there is a lady you are watching. You have made a plan to meet a man, and you lady, you have got 3 children. And you are planning to meet a man and have sex with this man, but you're already married. And this lady, the husband has been fighting prophets. But I told her, you are planning evil to do this against to betray your husband. Then she called and says, prophet, I'm the one. I've got 3 children in the way of mission. I'm planning to go and do something for another man, yet I'm already married because I am frustrated. My husband has been going for other women, so I wanted to do revenge. I helped that lady and she stopped. I prayed for the man got saved. But this man has been fighting prophets. Some of the people that are fighting the prophet and the prophetic anointing, it is not normal. So where you are watching, there are 2 people you are watching right now. You know, this ministry, God is using it, working through this means. But you see, you have seen what has happened, but I'm urging you, just sow a seed. If you have got a car, you want God to do something big for you. You know, upeleke chincho chikubaba. You have to give something that is paining you. What is paining? You know, God told Abraham, take your son, your only son, give to me. And the Bible says again, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So he said, there are things that will need you to take a step. Plant a seed. You can plant a plot. You can say, I've got many, many plots, or I've got a plot, but I want to give to God. I want to give to the man of God. I want to sell it and sponsor the TV program. Then maybe someone you're watching says, no, as for me, prophet, I have got a car. I don't want you, man of God, to fail to struggle. You should be failing to travel from Charleston to Okavango, very far, using buses. I want you to not to struggle anymore. I'm sowing a seed for the work of God so that you can do the work of God in a simple way. We've got a church in Malawi. We've got a church in South Africa. We've got a church in Chongwe, at Zalibu Community School, and we've got a church here in Lusaka at our church plot. Let me pick another call. There are many people that are calling. There are many people that are calling. Let me pick a call. Hello? Yes, how are you? Hello, how are you? Where are you calling from? Eh? Kukalomo. From Kalomo, okay. I'm prophesying to people right now. I'm live on TV. Yes, right now. Can I prophesy to you? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, can I speak into your life? Okay. Where you are right now, I'm seeing a house with 3 bedrooms. Is it true what I'm saying here? Say, speak loud. Is it true what I'm saying here? Hello, Mama. Hello, Mama.
Hello.
Yes, speak loud. Are you getting me?
Yes.
Okay. I'm saying, hello?
Hello.
Okay, I'm saying where you are right now. I'm seeing you. Okay. You are in the house that is 3 bedrooms. Okay, when I enter the bedroom, I'm seeing the white bed sheet and the, some small spots of lead, but faint. Okay, then I'm seeing a man who's out of the house. Okay, are you married?
Hello?
You are not married, but I'm seeing the man outside the house. Hello? I'm seeing a man outside the house. Simply means this man is not yet married you. Okay. Are you dating a man?
No.
I'm seeing a man. Just be honest, Mama.
Okay.
Eh?
Yes.
Yeah. Are you having a man that you are seeing?
Yes.
But why were you refusing? It was a mistake. Okay, God has forgiven you. There is a spirit of rejection. You are disappointed almost 3 times now. I'm seeing you working somewhere. Where are you working? In Kalomo. Who is a teacher? Eh? Yes. Okay, who is teaching? Hello, Mama, please.
Hello.
There are many people are calling. So if you are taking long to answer, you are disturbing other people who want to be helped again. I've seen someone who's a teacher. Who's a teacher? Okay. There is a problem upon your life, Mama. Okay. Each time when someone is approaching to marry you, that's the time you are getting disappointed. Hello?
Hello?
Okay. I'm seeing a man. I'm still seeing a man who's a teacher. Mm-hmm. Eh? You know someone who's a teacher, a man. Okay. No, you come back to me. I'm seeing a man who's a teacher, and this man, he looked at your uncle. Okay, hello?
Hello?
You have remembered something now?
Mm-hmm.
He's your uncle?
Mm-hmm.
He's a teacher? Okay, tell him that there are people who are planning to attack him. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, tell him and give him my number. Let him call me. I want to pray for him. Then I'm seeing a child, a girl, almost 7 years. And this child is born somewhere in May. Okay, is this your child?
Huh?
Is it your child?
No, I don't have a child.
Whose child is this?
My
auntie. Your auntie. The child has got a very bright future, but this time around there is a failure. Hello?
Hello?
There is a spirit of failure on the child, but the child is very, very bright. There is this someone who starts with the name M.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, do you know someone with that name?
That's M.
Yes. What's your name?
My name is
Ivy. You sure? Ivy, do you know memory?
Yes.
Who is she to you?
My friend.
Your friend. Tell her that I'm seeing people are celebrating her for a very beautiful wedding coming for her.
Okay.
Yeah. Then I'm seeing you again, a man that you are seeing getting into wedding with you.
Okay.
Can I prophesy to you?
Yes.
Okay. God has remembered you, Mama.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, let me pray for you. Are you ready for the prayer? I've spoken a lot of things. Kneel down. Okay, your eyes, as I'm seeing, right, I'm seeing you right now. Hello? You know, I think God is very amazing, eh?
Mm-hmm.
How can I speak about your house, your bedship, the bed, 3-bedroom, spoken about the uncle, I've spoken about the man that you are seeing, I've spoken about your friend, the memory, I've spoken about you as Ida, Ivy, I've spoken to you again about your career. You see, I've spoken a lot of things about your life. Do you believe that God has changed your life today? Do you believe it?
I believe.
So now, the last thing that God wants to touch is your eyes. You know?
Hello?
Your eyes. God wants to touch your eyes now.
Uh-huh.
Your eyes, sometimes you feel like there is sand.
Uh-huh.
You feel itching.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Now, take your right hand and put on your eyes. God wants to touch you right now. Father, in the name, are you ready for prayer?
Yeah.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you are not a dead God. You are a powerful God. Free in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, free. Receive your freedom now. In Jesus' name, you are free. Amen. Okay, I'm seeing you, something has moved out like smoke, and you're feeling so lighter now. Hello?
Hello?
Speak louder, you are very low.
Hello?
I'm seeing something has come out like smoke inside you, and you are feeling very lighter. You are free. Say thank you.
Thank
Hello? Glory be to Jesus. There is someone you are doing business. You have been to business. You are a car dealer. You are watching me right now. You are a car dealer. Okay. You have been to this business party. It's almost like 4 years now, but things are not moving. The problem is you are spending money to the girls. There is another man you are watching right now. You are a police officer. Your life is at a warning point. Anytime from now, you may lose your job because you are so much corrupt. You will be caught very soon. There is a doctor. This is UTH. Okay, I'm warning you. You are a lecturer, and you have been raping all the nurses that have been coming, the young nurses that have been coming to learn at that institution. So I'm warning you, be careful what you're doing. Stop it. God is calling for repentance. I can mention your name, but for the sake of this is media, I don't want to be traced and be followed up, but I'm warning, stop anytime you'll be arrested. There is another one you're watching, a lady you're watching. Mwana wanu wakufutani maningi mnyamata. Ari na 19 years, 10 to 20. Paper, start joining bad groups. You are watching me right now. You are giving up. Peace be with you all over. We are watching from all over Zambia, all over the world, all over Africa, all over the global, the whole continent of Africa, the whole world. This is Prophet Anthony Mofriwa. If you were ever watching from, you want to come and see me. God has called you, whether from Kitwe, from South Africa, wherever you are, you want to work with us, you are most welcome. If you want to come and see me one-on-one, just make an appointment to come and see me one-on-one. We have money to get the church plot, and we are building the church plot. We want to build a 50,000 capacity, but we are going to start small. The Lord has blessed us. We have got the anointing and power. Many things are happening. We have seen the dead people coming back. We have seen many people being healed. So the project has already started. As you are watching it, the project has started. I'm urging you that you can still support this program. The question is, God will ask you, and when you were on the earth, what did you do for my work? What did you do for my work? You're not just surviving for the sake of just existing, but you will survive for the sake of the work of God to go far. So I'm urging you, I'm talking to you, that car, take it as a seed. That prod, take it as a seed. You know, some of us were given bigger things, our iPads, our phone, some of us were given our suits, we have given a lot of money. Even this program that you are watching on TV, I sponsor it. So I'm talking to you that you can become one of the partners of this program. You can partner with me in this program. I want to touch many, many souls. I'm praying to God that this night of entrance and crossover, we want to be at Nungush Conference, or we want to be somewhere like Gabriel Conference or in the stadium. So I'm urging everyone, if you are very far, you cannot mind to come to church on Sunday. You can just send your money on Airtel money or on MTN money. Then you call for prophecy. We are not charging, but we are just asking you to contribute for this program to continue. You see, I'm not working. I don't sign anywhere at month end. The only work that I'm doing, it is the work of God. So I'm urging you to support. And I don't want to continue using members to come and do the work of God. Kabang is very far with Choston, and it's very difficult. But we are trying by all means that we can still serve God. We want to buy a bus that can pick people around to Lusaka. We want to build a very big church capacity. The project has already started. I'm urging, I'm inviting you. Our service is every 8 hours up to 13 hours, Sundays. And every Friday, 16 hours up to 19 hours, every Friday. Within the week, it's one-on-one session. You have to make an appointment and book and see me one-on-one. God bless you. Shalom.